Hey everyone, Mr. Bowen Plays here again, doing another Rogalo video. This time it's for the newly released Star Wars Bounty Hunter. I've actually never played this Star Wars game. I always looked at the front cover and I always thought, it didn't look that good, but seeing the trailers for it the past couple of months and stuff like that, I always thought, you know what, I'll try it. Hopefully it's a good port from Aspyr, I think that's the name of the company that done it, because their Star Wars Battlefront game was pretty buggy at launch, so hopefully this one's a bit smoother and runs well. So yeah, let's get into it. It's 10.2 gigabytes. So yeah, quite a big game for, I believe the original version was like 2 gigabytes, but they always increase like the video files in the games, so it's takes up more memory, obviously. I was originally gonna get the PS. I think it's on PS4. They ported it on that console back in the day, but apparently it was like a stray port, and the controls wasn't fixed. But this one's got like better controls and stuff now, so I'm pretty glad I waited and got this new version. It's also out on, I believe it's out on Xbox, I might be wrong on that, but I know it's out on Switch and PlayStation as well. Let's have a look at the settings, see what we got. Graphics, motion blurs off, ambient occlusion. Should be able to do extreme, surely. Blue. Dynamic shadows on, bump mapping on. Yeah, we'll put some low motion blur on. Dynamic lighting, we want that on as well. I hope we should be able to run this. I'll be shocked if it doesn't. We're currently at 10 watts as well. Let's try it on 10 watts. Should be 1080p as well. Yeah, 1080p. Display, 1080p, VSync on. Let's get into it then. Probably gonna get copyrighted for that then. Hopefully not. I love the good old Star Wars intro. So iconic. The one sad thing about this game is, well, technically, it's sad and it's not sad at the same time, because it depends if you were considered Disney stuff canon these days. But yeah, this game is totally not canon now because of Disney. I don't know, yeah, we can skip it. Okay, let's just skip it. Get into the game. Turn the volume up a bit. Ooh, the armor looks nice. Blast him. Is any bullets are bouncing off me? Oh no! It's got munched. So yeah, at 10 watts we can get in 60 frames. Which is decent. Whew. We just gotta let him hit the lasers, I think. There we go. Up. Oh. That was funny. can I do it again? Does it work? Oh no, I can walk through him now. Ooh, look at that. Pretty snazzy. I thought performance would be a bit better than this, to be fair. Let's try 15 watts. Seems a bit better. It's not where I'd want it to be, though, for an old game. Am I missing something? I am missing something. What are we gonna do? Nope. That's where I got this way. No. Okay, we're stuck. Back in a minute. Okay, so you'd never guess what. Where the hell do you think you would need to go? You think you need to go here? No. What about through here? Also no. Above you? No. Over here? Yes. Of all the spaces. Wait, no, wrong one. Not here, it's this over this side. Of all the things, that is pretty bad level design in my opinion. There's literally nothing, you can't even see it like that. I like the dynamic shadows and stuff though, it's really nice. Right there, let's see what's this way first. Nothing, just a dead end, okay. Make sure there's no hidden collectibles under there. Oops. There you go. Oh my God. Oh my God. I used to hold him back an A to do jumps in games, but no, this one you have to jump and then hold back. Django, some of Nico's thugs have decent prices on their heads, too. I'll transmit the info to your ID scanner. Oh, he's wanted to see it. Dead is worth 500 credits. Alive is worth 1,000 credits. So we'll try and keep him alive, eh? Is that it? I Maybe not that then. The darts, maybe? Is he dead or alive? He might be dead. We might have just killed him. Yeah, I'd say he's dead now. No bounty, okay. You sure, little droid? Yeah, I was expecting performance to be a bit better than this, to be fair. It's not exactly the best, is it? Let's check one of the settings. I bet it's ambient occlusion. Let's try that. Yeah, ambient occlusion seems to be a bit of a resource hog, even in this game, which is surprising. As you can see, never getting a lot better performance, but it doesn't look as nice. Let's try it with high ambient occlusion, see how we get on with that. No, that tank's performance as well. No, that's a bit better. We'll try it on high then. We'll keep it on high. Oh, shit. Ooh. Oof, I should have scanned him actually. One of them might have been a bounty. Thought I know. And he got squished by the doors, and let's just bring out my scanner.
You're near the pit fighter's training area. Brush up on your technique if you like.
Well, that sucked. I thought I was far enough away to not let it affect me. Obviously not. Wait, no, I need to go up, don't I? Oh boy. Are any of you bounties? No. No. One of you ugly bastards are going to be a bounty. Maybe not. Maybe not then. Wait. Which one's a bounty? You. Oh well. I'm trying to lock on, but it's not working. Oh shit, I should just I shouldn't have walked in there. So the controls are not perfect, it's still a bit janky. Oh, look at those dudes down there. Did you drop him for surprise? Oh boy. What was I doing in here? There's nothing in here. Very strange. So yeah, if you like what you see, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, help the channel grow. What are you all in like these little rooms for? You're dead? Yeah, you're dead. That's good then. There we go. So I need some health. Like I do all that jumping again and go back to the top of there. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no, oh my god. I can't believe I just did that. It's still very clunky. It's still very, floaty. Pretty fun though. It's gonna take a while to get used to. What's up here then? Is that door openable or not? No. Thank you. I can hit some more somewhere. Yeah, the jumping's really shit in this game, I'm not gonna lie. Look, this level design's really weird. Like, oh, fuck off. Like, you're walking here. It's just weird. I suppose you've got an arrow to go up, I suppose, but Jesus. I think the level design so far might be worse than Tomb Raider originals. Well, that didn't work. There's another one of them things. Where did he come from? I'm not going to. Where did he come from? That's so random. Level complete. Don't shoot. Did you hear me? Controls. They're going to take a lot to get used to, they're a bit fiddly. I mean, they're more modernised, but it's still very, twitchy, that makes sense. Like, jumping doesn't work as much as you'd want it to. Level design's a bit weird as well, like, I mean, some things just seem really, like, hidden. Like that bit of the, with the, like, little tunnel bit at the beginning, like, you couldn't even see it. I saw it when I was just walking around the room a lot, and I was like, oh, there's a little ditch here, and I went down here and I found it. I was like, oh, okay. But yeah, at least it works better than the last Star Wars game they ported to the PC and stuff. Would I recommend it? If you can get it for a decent price. I mean, I think it's like £15, 7p, because it had like 10% off the pre-sales, so I'd recommend it that way, but yeah, I'd say wait for a sale. I've been truthful. If you want to see more on the Rock Ally, then hit the like and subscribe button. I'll be posting more videos in the future, and there should be another one today as well, so I'll see you in the next one. Bye.